So returning now, agenda item number 16, Taupo Event Centre.
15. Dogs.
Oh, my wife will be watching.
Joe's friends.
I'll be sent to the dog. My humblest apologies to everybody, although the chairperson is allowed to change the agenda around. But that was accidental, I admit to that. Agenda item number 15, setting of dog control fees. Welcome, Mr. Mickelson. How are you, sir?
Your Worship. Woof, woof.
No dog bites. Proceed, my friend.
I think, Your Worship, we could take this item as being read and take any questions in relation to the issues, which I would suggest are fairly simple.
Okay, well, I made a request before the meeting so my fellow councillors know. In future, I would just like the staff to be conscious of the fact when we're setting fees with things like this, dog fees or any other sort of fees, could we please have comparisons from other districts so we have horses for courses, so to speak. I don't want to be part of a council that charges this for this and across the boundary. We sort of need to have a level playing field. So are those figures now available?
Mr. Chairman, they're being collated as we speak and
well, then, shall we adjourn this item?
The options are to adjourn it, or I do have the information for Rotorua and Whakatane in front of me. So
I'd just like to be able to look at
that now.
Otherwise, people say to us, oh, it's only this and it's that. Yeah. And so we already have the only ramps in New Zealand you have to pay for.
It is hard, Mr. Chairman, to compare the fees because everybody has a slightly different fee structure. They charge things differently. But if we look at two of our closer neighbours, Rotorua and Whakatane, they both charge $65 essentially for all dogs. When you look at our resolution on 15 bar 2, what we're suggesting here is that working dogs and special owner policy dogs, which remember those dogs that are good dogs essentially, and good owners, and have been properly fenced, etc., we're proposing a fee of $48. And as I say, Rotorua Whakatane are at $65. We do have a slightly higher fee for other dogs that aren't good dogs, and that's on the basis that we believe that good dog owners should pay less because they take less of our time, less of our care, and the not so good dog owners should pay slightly more. So that's to say, it is hard to compare apples to apples because there is different splits and different ways of providing your fees, but that's the justification behind that. You'll also see over on page 15 bar 3, we've also suggested some increases in the for really bad dogs that end up in our pound. And again, that's the very same philosophy that coming through those submissions you'll read. A lot of people said, hang on, as good dog owners, why are we covering the cost of bad dog owners? We understand the costs go up, but is that a fair split? We've re-looked at that and agree with those submissions as officers. So we're suggesting slightly higher fees for the really bad dogs, higher fees for the not so good owners and a lesser reduction for the good owners.
Now, if there's no other councillors at the moment, I just struggle with that a little bit, you know, like who's the judge and jury to say, oh, he's a bit of a bad dog, but he's a really bad dog and that one over there is a good dog? Who does
really
all this?
Dog, a really bad dog is one that ends up in the pound, and that's those fees on 15 bar 3.
So
that's the ones that end up being impounded. What I'm saying is a good dog is those dogs that meet the special owner policy proceedings, and that policy requires a property to be able to be accessed to the front door, so the back of the property fenced, requires that the dog hasn't been impounded by us or in trouble with us before. Neutering?
Some of them can be neutered, and others relate to barking.
Yeah, so complaints, have we had any complaints about that dog in the past? So they're the dogs that have... slash dog owners that haven't had any issues. If you don't meet that criteria, by default you become an other dog. You don't. You become an owner of another dog, and therefore it becomes the $85.
I was just struggling a little bit here, but someone else might want to ask the question. But the first three on 15 bar 2, when you go across the right-hand column, they all end up the same anyway, whether they're a working dog, a special dog, or a hunting dog. And then you've got other dogs.
Trying to simplify that, so it's simplifying the fees. Previously, we had the hunting dogs separately, so you'll see if you go down the first column, which is the current fees, 2010-2011, we had a fee for working dogs, we had a fee for special owners, dogs of 46, and a fee for hunting dogs of 39, and then all those other dogs that didn't meet any of those became the $82. What we're proposing now is essentially to have only the two categories, so we have hunting dogs working dogs for the first five, and the special owner dogs at $48, and then everything else is $85. So it's just a grouping in terms of that.
So where's a poodle go?
A poodle, if it met the criteria of a special owner, they would go into the $48 category.
And if the little poodles didn't have a special owner, he'd be $85.
The little poodle had been had a whole lot of complaints and been impounded by us and things like that. It would be $85. Yes.
His name is Cujo. Look out. Can I just ask that?
Until a minute.
I've got a dog, so I register it the next time. And when I register it, is that when all of a sudden you go, "Oh, your dog's been troubled. You're now another dog." When does that point? Just so I can understand.
You've got to make an application with us under the special owner policy. You've got to make an application to be a special owner, which is where.
All other dogs. Sorry, how do I know it becomes an all other dog? Sorry.
So anybody who's not a special owner, a hunting dog or a working dog, which they've got to apply for, is an all other dog. So to become a one of those other categories, you've got to make an application to us. We've got to assess the records. Okay. We've got to come over and have a look at your section to make sure that you meet the requirements, and then you become a special owner. And that can happen any time of the year. Everybody else is the all other dogs.
All other dogs is by default.
And that's the same process that we've had in place for the last 10 years without issue.
Councillor Henderson? I was just going to say that I fully support the approach taken subsequent to the consultation, and that the proposed 25% increase in dog fees that was here for registration has been dropped. I guess you'd call it the good dog, bad dog policy. But my question relates to... If you're going to put the charges more onto the bad dog owners, or the very bad, bad dog owners, they're often accompanied by pretty bad owners. What's the issue is with collecting and enforcement and that sort of thing? I'm just curious what the rates are and what the processes are for that, briefly, anyway.
Like anything, when we do this across a number of areas in terms of our infringements, we're often dealing with people like that. Essentially, the way the process works is that if the infringement notices remain unpaid after certain periods,
so you pursue all through that process?
It's up to us as we go through. Okay. If there's a really good justification or reason, we may decide to waive that fee. Or it's an ongoing process.
Largely, you get your money at the end of the day?
To varying degrees of success, yes.
Okay, any further questions? Are you comfortable with this and had a look at, seems to me there's a lot of judge and jury in here. To me, a dog's a dog. Sorry, but a dog's a dog to me. It smells like fish, looks like fish, it is fish. And if you want to own a dog, you're part of the whole gambit in the Taupo District, unfortunately, in my opinion. But there's a lot of judge and jury work you guys are having to do.
I think there's a whole lot of work that we're going to do and bring up as part of the LTP, and that's around the funding policy split. So how dog control in general was funded. Obviously, the function costs council a certain amount of money. At the moment, we fund part of that out of rates, and that's to take into account unregistered dogs who can't contribute as visiting dogs, etc., and percentages out of fees. What we'll be asking as part of the funding policy that Neil spoke about before is that current split right? And then we'll be looking at the fee structure, and is that the right way to do the fee structure and the right split? We believe that that's the right place to do that, because there's a whole lot of work at the moment with trying to get as close as possible to that or to reflect the increases in doing the business, the increase of food and petrol in particular, and electricity, without having the major increase, which obviously we got some fairly strong messages through the submission process about.
So are you telling me, Mr. Green, that that the general ratepayer is subsidising the overall dog situation in the Taupo District? In other words, what I'm trying to say is, are the fees collected in totem covering the cost of dog control?
It's meeting the funding policy split, which is 50% of the cost.
So 50% of the ratepayers are funding the dog issue in the district?
The ratepayer is funding 50% of the cost of the operation, and dog owners are recovering the funding the remaining 50%.
So if dog owners had to fund their whole dog issue, they'd be at least double this. And the ratepayer wouldn't be subsidising it at all, would he?
The doubling would be the doubling of around about what we propose, so the second column in, rather than what we propose.
So just for my simple brain, so what we're collecting in would only go around about 50% of the cost of running the dog whole dog issue in the Taupo District. Good dogs, bad dogs, and really bad dogs.
Can I ask just comparisons with other districts, if that 50-50 split's in place?
Different districts have different splits. They are never 100%. I've never seen 100%. And that's on the basis, again, that would mean that good dog owners were paying for all of our work that happens to unregistered and bad dogs. So it's always a split there to varying degrees. The average would be around somewhere between 40 and 60%.
Just for the councillors' sake, I don't think we've done any funding policy rounds yet, have we? But you will in your LTP. That's when you decide what the split should be. And if you were to say, for argument's sake, that currently the split is 50-50 and you wanted to go 70% dogs and 30% ratepayer, you would have to raise your dog fees up or down, you know, whatever you decide in your policy. But that's the policy at the moment, 50-50.